Good morning students, Sairam, welcome you all in our next session of online classes. So students, we have already done our two part of this chapter, which is financial management. Now in this third part, we are going to continue our chapter. Student, this is very important chapter and too long, so that it is also divided into four parts, okay? So this chapter number 9, financial management, is divided into 4 videos. Okay, now in our third video, we are going to start again. Students, as we learned that the financial decision is divided into 3 parts, like number 1 is financing decision, 2nd dividend decision, and 3rd one is investment decision. As I said, or as we learned in our previous video, that the investment decision is also divided into 2 terms, which is long term investment or short term investment. Means if we take decision that how we and for which we have to invest, so we have 2 platforms, long term or short term, that we have to invest on a long term plan, or we have to invest in a short-term plan. Long-term is called capital budgeting, means if we invest our money to the fixed asset is known as capital budgeting or long-term decision. And if we invest in working capital management, means current assets, if we invest our money to the day-to-day requirement, to fulfill the day-to-day requirement of a company, is known as working capital, okay? And it is also known as short term decision. Now capital budgeting means it is a most crucial financial decision for the firm. It refers to the selection of an assets. What we do here, we select the assets or investment proposal or course of the action whose benefits are likely to be available in future over the lifetime of the project. Means what we have to decide, that on which asset we have to invest or which project we have to invest, whether it is a long term or short term. Means the first thing which we see, the rate of return. Means if the rate of return is maximum, so that we invest in a long term plan. Okay, rate of return, we can say that the profit. Now what are the factors which affect while deciding in investment in a capital budgeting or a long term plan? First, what we have to do, first we check the cash flow of the project. If the project is long term, for example it is of 10 years project, okay, so if we have the cash flow for the next 10 years for their capital budgeting, so that we invest. But the cash flow position means the reserve, the position of a company, means the cash in hand or cash at the bank is not available as per the long term project, so we will not take a risk. Okay, so if we invest our money in a capital budgeting in a long term plan, so first what we do, we have to check our cash flow position, the pocket of the company, that the money is there for the long term investment or not. Next, what we see, if we take risk and invest and think about the investment in the long term plan, the next thing what we have to check, the return, the rate of return. If the rate of return is maximum, if we think okay, I will invest in that long term plan, but the rate of return is not so good, so this is not a profitable deal, so what we do, we have to check whether the rate of return is good or not. If the rate of return is higher, then we have to take risk to invest in that long term project. Next one is investment criteria. Next, the other thing which comes under the mind of financial manager, that what is the investment criteria, means the formalities and the rules, regulation, policies. This also like the operating cost, these are the some things which need extra money. So if the investment criteria is smooth, then we will take a risk. If it is not smooth or it is also may create a burden on our cash flow, that means it is not a profitable. So these are three factors which affect while we deciding to invest in long term plan or long term investment, which is called capital budgeting. Next one is working capital management. What is working capital management? It is concerned with the management of current assets. The key strategy consideration in ensuring a trade-off between the profitable and liquidity is one of the major dimension of working capital management. In working capital management, what we do, we have to select that what which current asset we have to invest so that make profitable for our future. Like efficient management of individual current assets such as cash, receivables and inventories. These are some example which is basically profitable if we think about the working capital budgeting. Okay, now next topic is financial planning. Look students, financial planning, this is a combination of two words, financial and planning. Planning, we have already learned what is planning, to forecast, to deciding in advance that what to do, how to do, for whom to do. What is this? This is a planning. What the planning do? Link the past or the present with the future. It play a role of a bridge. Okay, now here the what is the meaning of financial planning? Financial planning mean what is the meaning of financial? Financial means related to money, means finance, which is required to run, to start or to operate a business. So if we plan that about the finance, so it is a combination. So with the combination of two words, and the new word comes, which is financial planning. So what is the financial planning basically mean? When we plan about the finance, that where to we have to invest, from where we get money. So these are the basic thing which comes when we do financial planning. So students, I hope you all have understood what is the meaning of financial planning. We combine finance with the planning. This is called financial planning. Means if we plan, if we forecast our financial needs, that what is this? Financial planning. Okay, now definition. Financial planning pertains to the function of finance and includes the determination of firm's financial objective, financial policies and financial procedures. Look student, what is the main aim of the financial planning is to think about the sources, about the objective of enhancing money, for available money at that time, so that we do the financial policies and make financial and also follow the financial procedure, so that we achieve our objective. So what is the financial planning do? Financial planning make available the cash flow position of a company stable always. Okay, now what it means that deciding in advance how much to spend. What is the planning do? What to do, how to do. Here when we talk about the money, then how much to spend, first thing which comes under the mind of a financial manager, that how much to spend and on what to spend according to the firm's disposal. Means what the financial manager do after coming the profit, he distribute the profit to the shareholders and keep some part of that as a general reserve or as a retained earning. So here when we talk about the financial planning, so from our firm's disposal, means from our firm's general reserve, what to spend and how much to spend is who decide that? This decide financial planning. Okay, now financial planning includes students. What the other things that the financial planning includes? It includes the determination of finance of fund needed, means what it determine, what it do. It determines the finance of the fund needed, means determination of fund, that the finance which a company need. Okay, next one is determination of sources of finance, to find out from where we acquire money, whether from the debentures, whether from the equities, from the banks, from the financial institution. So these are the sources which it includes. Next one, determination of suitable policies for proper utilization of resources. Next step is to determine that what are the perfect and efficient policies which is useful for the proper utilization of resources and reduces the wastages of money. So what it financial planning includes? It includes the determination of finance for the firm which is needed, and determination of sources from where we acquire money. Okay, and next one is determination of suitable policies for the better utilization of resources according to the financial planning. Next one is most important thing. What is the objective behind doing financial planning? So what is the main objective if we do a financial planning? We do financial planning for our company to ensure that the availability of fund is there whenever it required. So what is the main objective of financial planning? Is to ensure availability of fund whenever it required. Another objective of financial planning is to see that the firm does not raise the fund unnecessary. Means first one is to ensure the availability of fund whenever required, and another thing is to see whether the firm raise fund unnecessary or invest in unnecessary projects or unnecessarily it spend on purchasing over resources and etc. So what the next thing? To see that the firm does not raise fund unnecessary. It raise fund whenever it required. Okay, now next one is significance. The most important thing why we do financial planning, why it is important, what is the need of financial planning? Number one is it is helpful in efficient operation of business objective. Students, if we manage things, so we do planning. So management, if we do the management of finance, management of money, so planning is also required. If we want that the business run smoothly with a smooth cash flow. Next one is because what the financial planning do? It maintain the liquidity in the organization so that they use the money whenever required. Next one is helpful in proper capitalization. If the liquidity is there, the money is there, then they easily capitalize whenever they require. Next, helpful in optimum capital structure. They also maintain the capital structure. What is the capital structure? Means from where they raise money, from the debentures, from the equity. So while deciding how much we raise from the equity, how much we raise from the debenture, so this thing also comes under the mind that according to the financial planning, what is our cash flow position, and according to that, if it is beneficial to raise money from the debenture or not. So these also, this thing also helpful and needed financial planning. Next one is helpful in proper utilization of fund. It is another objective of the financial planning. That means if we do financial planning, we it is very helpful for proper utilization of fund, that we know what amount of money invest to what purpose and what amount of money invest to the another purpose and what amount of money we have to keep with us for the meeting future requirements. So this is there. Now next one is helpful in expansion of the business. Look students, as I said many times that we keep our reserve from the profit as a retained earning, so that what it helps, it is a part of financial planning, na, that we keep some amount as general reserve as a retained earning, so that we spend this amount for the growth of the business, for the expansion of the business, for purchasing new machinery, new techniques. So what is this? This is the financial planning. This is because of the financial planning. So students, let's review again. Student, this is a little typical topic, so that's why I divided this chapter into four parts, so that you easily understood. So what is the financial planning? Deciding in advance what to do, how to spend, and on what to spend according to the cash flow position of a company. Okay, and what is the financial planning all includes? It includes the fund, determination of fund which is needed in a company or in a firm. Next one, determination of sources of finance, that the needed fund from where I get, from where I require or we acquire. Next one is determination of suitable policies for the proper utilization of funds. Means what are the proper policies or efficient policies so that the resources are fully utilized. So the objectives of financial planning is to ensure the availability of goods whenever it required. It maintain the liquidity so that the company easily invest and do their expenses. Next one is to see that the firm does not raise fund unnecessarily. Next, so what are the significance of financial planning? It is helpful in efficient operation of business activity. It is helpful in proper capitalization, helpful in optimum capital structure, helpful in proper utilization of fund, and helpful in expansion of business. So students, this part of financial planning we have completed. Now we will discuss in our next video the capital structure. Student, capital structure is, we can say that it is a part of financial planning. Means in financial planning we decide what is the capital structure, means from where we acquire money, what are the sources, and there are two main sources which comes under the capital structure: equity and debenture. That what ratio is to raise the money from the equity and from the debenture. So there is some numericals also from which I will explain you, okay, in our next video. So some capital structure are also having some point like fixed capital structure and working capital structure. So this capital structure portion is remaining, and we will continue that, or we will complete that portion in our next video. Thank you, Sairam.